Basic First Aid, presented by Carly Guerra for Tomorrow's Leaders Today. This is our outline for the presentation. We'll be walking through what is first aid, basic components of a first aid kit, and how to administer first aid in a variety of situations. What is first aid? First aid is the emergency or immediate care you should provide when a person is injured or ill, until full medical treatment is available. For minor injuries or illnesses, first aid may be enough. For serious problems, first aid should be continued until professional care can be administered. Administering first aid can mean the difference between life and death. First aid kits are a great way to be prepared for any emergency, and many of them are small enough to take anywhere. Some common first aid kit items include antibacterial wipes, painkillers, gauze pads, sunscreen, medical gloves, medical instrument kit, a sling, burn gel, antibiotic ointment, antiseptic wipes, first aid instructions, and a tourniquet. The first step in any emergency is to check the scene for any danger before you provide help. Remove the person from any potential danger. Step 2 is to call emergency services. The operators will ask you a series of questions to determine the seriousness of the injury. They can also guide you through the proper first aid techniques. Step 3 is to provide care. Use basic first aid skills to try and treat injuries and remain with the injured person until professional help arrives. CPR. You should start CPR on a person if they are not breathing, they are unresponsive, or they don't have a pulse. While you start chest compressions, have someone call 911 or emergency services. Compressions are hard and fast in the center of the chest with one hand on top of the other. When emergency services arrive, let them take over. Compressions should be done at a rate of 100 beats per minute, and compressions can be done to the beat of Staying Alive or Hips Don't Lie. If a person is choking, you can either perform 5 backflips or perform the Heimlich maneuver. In order to perform the Heimlich maneuver, you must first stand behind the person or kneel if it's a child. Make a fist with one hand, position it slightly above their belly button, grab the fist with the other hand, and press hard into the abdomen with a quick upward thrust as if trying to lift the person up, and continue performing until the person stops choking. Burns. The first step to treating a burn is to stop whatever is causing the burn. If it's a chemical burn, clean off the chemicals or remove the heat source. For serious burns, call 911. Flush the burned area with cool, not cold, running water. Do not use ice. Apply light gauze. Do not apply anything to the burn. Take ibuprofen or acetaminophen for the pain. Do not break any blisters that occur, and always seek medical attention for serious burns. Allergic reactions. Allergic reactions can be triggered by foods, medicines, animals, among other things. Mild symptoms of allergic reaction include itching, skin redness, slight swelling, stuffy, runny nose, itchy, watery eyes, and hives. Severe symptoms of an allergic reaction include swelling of the tongue or mouth, trouble swallowing or speaking, wheezing or trouble breathing, belly pain, nausea, vomiting, or diarrhea, dizziness, or fainting. Treatments for mild allergic reaction include taking an over-the-counter antihistamine like Benadryl. For swallowing, redness, or itching, a topical cream or ice can be used to treat it. Always contact a medical professional if the symptoms persist. For severe allergic reaction, call 911 for immediate medical help, or it can also be treated by using an EpiPen. The most severe allergic reaction is anaphylactic shock, which is a life-threatening allergic reaction. The best way to treat it is with an epinephrine pen, also known as the EpiPen. The first step is to keep the person calm, ask if they use an EpiPen and if they have one. Have the person lie on their back and keep their feet elevated. Avoid giving them food, drink, or medicine, and give them their EpiPen if they have one. If not, seek immediate medical attention. First aid for bleeding. Most bleeding can be controlled. Mild bleeding will usually stop on its own. Apply pressure to stop the bleeding. Cover the wound with gauze or cloth. Do not remove the cloth, instead add more layers if needed. Elevate the wound above the heart if possible. Continue to apply pressure until bleeding stops. For serious bleeding, call 911. For deep wounds, a tourniquet can be applied. how to apply a tourniquet. Tourniquets are tight bands used to completely stop blood flow to a wound. Tourniquets can be created using a belt, cloth, or towels and should be used only in serious situations. Position the material around the limb about 4 inches above the wound, closest to the heart. When using fabric, create a knot using a stick or pen and twist to tighten and keep it in place. Continue to apply direct pressure to the wound even after you apply the tourniquet. Always call 911 and seek immediate medical attention after applying a tourniquet. First aid for cuts and scrape. The first step is to clean the wound by gently running clean water over it. Avoid using soap in an open wound. Next, apply antibiotics to the wound like Neosporin and cover with a bandage. Fractures and sprains. All extremity injuries need to be treated as broken bones until an x-ray can be obtained. Do not strain the limb, instead stabilize it by using a splint and padding to keep it immobile. Put a cold pack onto the injury, do not put ice directly onto the skin. Elevate the limb to help reduce swelling. Always seek emergency help as soon as possible. Heat exhaustion occurs due to prolonged exposure to high temperatures, especially when the person is doing strenuous activities or hasn't had enough water. Symptoms include cool, moist skin, heavy sweating, dizziness, weak pulse, muscle cramps, nausea, and headaches. To treat someone with heat exhaustion, get the person to a shaded area out of the sun. Give the person water and keep them hydrated. Place a cool cloth on their forehead to lower their temperature and contact a doctor or 911. Bee stings. The first step to treating bee stings is to get the stinger out using either a pair of tweezers, a credit card, or tape. If the person is known to be allergic to bee stings, use an EpiPen to prevent anaphylaxis, shock, or call 911. Use a cold pack to reduce swelling at the site. Use an antihistamine like Benadryl to reduce swelling and itching. Try ibuprofen or Tylenol for pain. Monitor the person who is stung for signs of anaphylactic shock. Nosebleeds. Have the person sit down to help prevent dizziness. Have them lean their head slightly forward, not back, to help prevent blood from getting in their stomach and making them feel sick. Do not blow the nose. Instead, pinch below the bridge, but leave the nostrils open. Check after 5 minutes to see if the bleeding has stopped. If not, continue pinching and check after 10 minutes. Once a blood clot is formed, the bleeding will stop. If the bleeding doesn't stop after 15 minutes, contact your physician or call 911 if the bleeding is serious. Hope to learn more. This presentation is just a basic overview of first aid, and more information can be found through the American Red Cross. First aid and CPR classes are available through the Red Cross and similar organizations. They are often offered at medical centers, community centers, online, and through some schools. Thank you for watching this presentation. This was presented by Carly Guerra for Tomorrow's Leaders Today.